During the winter of 2005, health students from the University of South Florida put their skills to use in the Dominican Republic. USF Health, making life better today. Making life better tomorrow. Making life better for years to come. ...1,000 miles from home in a country one-third the size of Florida. A diverse group of USF students partnered with the Peace Corps volunteer to enhance the lives of everyone they touched. Shortly after arriving at the small village outside of Nagua, the challenges of living in a poor rural community surface. Students experienced firsthand life without the convenience of flushing toilets and running water.
They survive basically by catching just rainwater and filling up large barrels.
But outside the rainy season, and to supplement the rainwater collected from the rooftop, the community will take water from a shallow groundwater well.
Some families have latrines, others don't. While this family has its own pit latrine, the toilet is far from sanitary.
Some of the latrines you'll find in this community are absolutely miserable, just sanitary nightmares. These are pit latrines, so these are go underground, and this hole, I can't say how deep it's dug, but I imagine it's dug 8, 10, 12 feet under, which means it's into the water table, and so the fecal matter going down there is going to get into the groundwater and contaminate the groundwater.
And there lies the problem. Families use water contaminated by pit latrines for cooking, drinking, and washing. The sullied water also seeps into the surrounding canals, places where children often swim. Contaminated water can result in eye and ear infections and diarrhea, which can be deadly. One innovative solution, replacing pit latrines with compost latrines.
These latrines are above ground composting latrines, so that the waste put in the latrines will never make it to the waterway.
A compost latrine has two holes, so after a year of use you can cap one side, and the old waste material, which has been composting for a year, can then be used for fertilizer, and thereby improving human health. USF's International Health Service Collaborative brought 30 members to the Dominican Republic to improve the quality of life here. IHSC includes students from the colleges of nursing, medicine, and public health.
I didn't expect to get along with them so well as I have. I'd have made about 28 new friends.
Because multiple tasks were involved in constructing latrines, cooperation, passion, and leadership were vital. This team will cut the rebar. It will be up to another group to tie the wires. After initial steps are completed, students and locals united for the daunting task of raising a cement cap into position. The group from USF teamed up with the Peace Corps volunteer serving in the Dominican Republic and together helped build several toilets. By the end of his assignment, the volunteer says he expects to build 45 compost latrines in this community. He says the latrines are possible thanks in part to USF Health students.
I'm grateful that they're all using their vacation to come down here and do this project, because it's gonna advance the project significantly.
This team effort is sure to continue when the USF contingent leaves. The latrines cost each family about $12, roughly one-fifth their monthly income. Locals we spoke to tell us they're focused on the future.
It's very important for the environment for us to do this. It helps out, you know, the necessities that they have to use the restroom and stuff like that. He, again, was saying how grateful he was, and specifically that the project would last a very long time for them as well as their kids.
The challenges of living in a poor rural community take on new meaning as IHSC participants visit individual homes. The scene here is common throughout the Dominican Republic. About 40% of the population lives in small, scattered communities, each with 10 to 200 families. During the house calls, infectious disease fellow Igor Malnichek guided students from the colleges of medicine and public health through real-world learning experiences. As the USF contingent went from house to house checking on the health of the villagers, the same problem surfaced time and time again: diarrhea, diabetes, and high blood pressure.
So they don't have much of protein, so they eat rice. It's digestible, and it's always high workload for the pancreas. As a result, pancreas finally just, you know, gives up.
Children and adults often complained about stomach pains, too.
Well, again, same story. This guy has the same type of diarrhea for about 3 days, 4 times a day. So, you know, can it vomit us, no? Those two pills for those, too.
I think it makes you strong as a person and just broadens your horizons. And hopefully it will allow you to become a more better, more compassionate doctor or nurse.
For residents unable to take part in the house visits, the USF contingent held a free health clinic. Before the doors opened, men, women, and children lined up for professional care and advice. In less than 2 hours, IHSC participants handed out more than 100 antiparasitic medicines. The pills would help counter diseases caused by unsanitary conditions. And USF's infectious disease fellow teamed up with the local doctor to treat patients. IHSC leaders agree reaching out to the community enhanced the lives of everyone they touched. In all, the USF contingent donated about $30,000 worth of medicine, which included antibiotics, diabetes medicine, and blood pressure medicine. While the group offered immediate care by dispensing medicine, students also provided sustainable health by building compost latrines and educating school children.
A group of us came up with the idea of introducing one of our members with glitter on his hand and to demonstrate how bacteria is transmitted with dirty hands.
The skits offered lessons on the importance of hand washing, basic sanitation, and oral rehydration. USF students also stressed the benefits of brushing teeth.
It was a little overwhelming at first, but you know, they were all kids and they were so involved and so excited for us to be there. Like, it was great. I liked it a lot.
Not only did the school children learn a lesson or two, so did USF students.
This project, I think, has really proven that students want to work together. They've gotten together, they're becoming friends, collaborating really well together, working well. And that's exactly what I'd hoped to happen.
For this Dominican community, USF Health students are making life better.